Whether working as a CG or a compositing artist, once you've solved your shot inside of Mocha Pro, you might want to have proper geo in your scene without round-tripping back and forth to another application. I'm Christoph Zapletal for Boris Effects, and in this quick tip, I'm going to show you how you can snap geometry to your object track inside of Mocha Pro. In this shot, I already performed an object track of the car, consisting of the side and the back of the vehicle. Also, I solved the scene using the camera solver. Let's switch through the different 3D views just to give you a feeling for what is happening in this scene. This looks quite good, but then again, to really judge the alignment, having a proper car in this scene would make this much easier. Let's import some geometry. Mocha Pro supports USD Geo, so if your geometry is in a different file format, you can use, for example, Blender to convert it. That is what I did in this case. Now you will see that my car geometry here is not really aligned to our ground plane, but rather taking a proper nosedive right into it. There's a simple fix and a slightly more complex explanation for this. Let's start with the explanation first. Mocha uses a Y-up coordinate system. You can see that indicated here by the colors of our axis, with red representing the X-axis, green the Y-axis, and blue the Z-axis. And to show this very obviously, if we take our misaligned car and change the Y parameter, it moves vertically in our scene. Blender, on the other hand, uses a Z-up coordinate system. So to remedy this problem, we need to realign the geo. We could do this inside of Blender, but as Mocha has got everything we need for this, let's just rotate our car minus 90 degrees along the X-axis. If we shuttle through our scene now, we see the car sitting correctly on the ground plane, but not being correctly rotated along the road, and also not being scaled correctly. Much more importantly, it is not moving with our object track. Let's fix that second part first. I'm going to select my car geometry in the 3D objects list and select Snap To. And then I'm going to select the object I want to snap to. I'm going to choose the center point of the side surface of the object track. That will now align with the pivot of my USD car. As this pivot was sitting on the ground plane before, my car is now slightly elevated, but we'll fix that in a second. Before, I just want to make sure that the geo is correctly attached to my object track. This just travels along nicely. Now I can switch to my 3D top view and align the car. The two surfaces of my object track serve as great guides in aligning scale and rotation of the car. In the left view, I can then bring the car down a bit and make sure that the pivot of the car is once again aligned with the ground plane. Returning to my camera view, I can now do the final alignment. Note that this 3D model is not exactly for the car filmed in this scene, but full car replacement is a pretty common task in commercials. In a scenario like this, you want to keep the parts of the car that actually interact with the ground from the original footage, so let's align it to the tires. With the geo in place, it is now much easier to see if our track holds up. Would our solve be inaccurate, we would see jumps or slides in the geo's alignment. While looking at this is great, working with the geo is much more fun. However, there are limitations that you need to be aware of. You can export the geo by saving your camera data as either a synthesized scene or as an alembic file. In other export formats, your geo will be replaced by a null object. I'm going with Alembic, and I'm going to choose to export all objects. However, I don't want to have all my trackers visible as chisels in my Alembic, so to avoid that, I'm going to switch export points from individual meshes to nulls. Inside of Nuke, I will call up a ReGeo node and choose my Alembic file. Nuke will automatically provide the camera as a separate node, and the ReGeo node will display my car as expected. However, our two planar surfaces from the object solve are still in there as well. To remove them, go up to your ReGeo properties and select the Scene Graph tab. There we can quickly turn off those two shapes. Now we've got a nice moving geo inside of Nuke. Just double check that the frame rate of both the camera and the ReGeo node are identical to your footage's frame rate, to make sure nothing drifts over time. This geo can now be used for everything from reprojection to shadow creation to relighting and much more. Being able to attach geo to your object tracks inside of Mocha Pro will surely offer you smoother workflows between Mocha and your favorite compositing or CG package. If you want to test drive Mocha yourself, visit us at borisfx.com and get your free trial. There you'll also find great tutorials on all kinds of topics, including a proper deep dive into object solving inside of Mocha Pro's camera module. I'm Christoph Zapletal for Boris Effects, and I will see you in another video.